Good morning, everyone. This is Sherline of Kathanika, and today I'm going to tell you a story. So settle down and listen. Now, this is a story about how rabbits discovered that they love broccoli leaves. Did you know that? Rabbits love broccoli leaves. And here is how it all began. Now, many years ago, there was a rabbit. And at that time, the rabbits had a very long tail, like the cat's tail. And the cats didn't have any tails at all. Can you imagine that? Cats with no tails and rabbits with long cat-like tails. Well, that is how it was. And the cat, oh, he was envious of the rabbit's tail. Oh, if I just had a tail like that, thought the cat, what all would I do with it? Ah, I would swish it in the air. I would puff it up. I would do so many things with the tail. If only I had a tail like that. Now, one morning, lazy morning, the rabbit was lying on a warm rock and he fell fast asleep with his mouth open and his tail lying down from the rock hanging there. And the cat was on his morning walk and he came across the rabbit. And he saw that beautiful, beautiful tail and the cat could not resist. He said, I must have that tail. I simply must have the tail. Now the cat had an old rusted knife. So he took that knife and he went up to the rabbit and he cut off the rabbit's tail. And then he quickly sat down, got out a needle and thread and began sewing the tail to himself. Now while the cat was busy doing this, the rabbit woke up. He woke up and he looked at the cat who was still busy swinging the tail to himself. And the rabbit said, hey, cat, what are you doing? Is that my tail? And the rabbit looked at where his tail was and saw, are, did you just steal my tail, cat? And the cat quickly sewed up the tail to himself and he said, yes, rabbit, it is your tail. But see how lovely it looks on me. I think it suits me better than you. So the rabbit said, you took my tail. Oh dear, how could you do this? The cat said, oh, but it looks nice on me, na? See, see. And he started swishing the tail around. The rabbit said, oh, not fair, not fair. You've taken my cat tail, you've taken my tail. Then the rabbit looked up at the cat and said, okay, now I'm a good fellow. I'm a reasonable fellow. So it's fine. You can keep my tail. But you must give me something in return. So the cat said, what can I give you? So the rabbit looked at that rusty knife and he said, how about that knife? The cat said, that is my knife. He said, so what? You've taken my tail, no? So now you give me that knife in exchange. So the cat said, no, it's my knife. The rabbit said, no, you have to give me that knife or you give me back my tail. You give me the knife or you give me my tail. Give me the knife or give me the tail. Give me the knife or give me the tail. The rabbit started chanting. The cat was getting terribly tired and he definitely did not want to give the tail. So he threw that knife at the rabbit and said, take that knife and I'm going off now. The cat walked away. The rabbit took that rusted knife and he looked at himself and he said, ha, what use was that tail to me? Useless thing, it was just hanging around there. I lost the tail, but it's okay. I have gained a knife. And the rabbit happily started hopping around. He thought, chalo, I'll go for a walk. And the rabbit hopped and reached the banks of the river. Now on the banks of this river, there were marshes. And in that marshes, there grew reeds. And the rabbit came upon an old man who was sitting there on a rock. And he had cut off those reeds and he was weaving baskets. Now, reeds are these long, supple, bamboo-like thing of which you make baskets. And the man was weaving baskets. And he was using his teeth to cut off the reeds when the basket was done or while he was weaving the basket. So the rabbit observed this and he said to the old man, hey old man, Ah, you're using your teeth to cut off those reeds? Arey arey, your teeth will start paining. So the old man said, "Yes, but what can I do? I need to weave these baskets." So the rabbit, who was a generous fellow, he said, "Hey, old man, you know what? See, I've got a rusted knife. If you want, you can use my knife." So the old man said, "Really? You are giving me your knife to use?" So the rabbit said, "Yeah, take, you can use it. And when you're done, you can return it back to me." So the man said, "That's really nice of you. That's really kind of you." And he took the knife from the rabbit and he started weaving the baskets. Now, you know, the knife was very old. So he wove one basket, he wove two baskets. When he used it for the third time, tadak, the knife broke. The rabbit saw the knife broke and said, The old man said, "Hurry, it was an old knife and I did not mean to break it. It broke." "No, you broke my knife. You broke my knife. Now give me back my knife. Put it together and give me back my knife." So the old man said, "How can I give you back your knife? It's already broken." So the rabbit said, "No, you give me my knife. Now give me my knife." Old man said, "I'm sorry, I can't do anything." So he said, "No, give me my knife or give me something else." So the old man said, "What can I give?" So the rabbit said, "That basket, basket, basket. Give me one basket. You've broken my knife, na? Now give me one basket." So the old man said, "Arey, but that basket I have to go and sell in the market and then I'll get money and I can feed my family." Rabbit said, "Nothing doing. I don't know. You broke my knife. Now give me my basket. Give me one basket. You give me the knife, just give me my basket. Give me the knife or give me the basket. Give me the knife or give me the basket." The rabbit started chanting. The old man was getting really tired of this rabbit. So he looked and he saw among his baskets, there was one old basket. So he picked up that basket and he gave it to the rabbit and said, "Take, take, take this basket." So the rabbit took it and he said, and he hopped away. And as the rabbit hopped away, he said, "Theek hai, fine, not bad. I lost my tail, but I gained a knife. I lost the knife, but I gained a basket." And the rabbit took the basket and he happily began hopping away. Now, hopping, 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 he came to a farm, a vegetable farm. And on that vegetable farm, there was growing green, green broccoli. Rows and rows of nice emerald green broccoli, just waiting to be harvested. And in that farm, there was an old lady. Now, that old lady, she would go cut off one broccoli and she would run to one shed. Tuck, 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 tuck. Run to the shed and she would keep that broccoli. And then she would come running back to the rows of broccoli. Tuck, 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 tuck. And she would cut one more head of broccoli. And then she would go running back to the shed, keep that head of broccoli, come back, go again, come back, go again. The rabbit was sitting and watching her. The rabbit went to her and said, "Old lady, what are you doing?" So the old lady said, "I'm harvesting broccoli." Rabbit said, "But why are you taking one and running and keeping and coming back? Can't you take two, three together?" The old lady said, "I would love to do that, but I don't have anything to carry the broccoli in." So the rabbit said, "Arey, then look at this. I have a basket. And you can use my basket. So you can cut four or five of the broccoli, put it in the basket, and then go and keep it to the in your shed and come back. It will save you so much trouble." So the old lady said, "Arey, rabbit, you're so generous. How nice, good. Thank you so much." And she took the basket. Rabbit said, Ha, okay. Use it carefully. Yeah? And after you're done, nah, give me back my basket, okay?" Old lady said, Yeah, sure. She took the basket and now she started chopping three, four broccoli, put it in the basket. Then she would run to her shed, put down the broccoli and come back again. Now she did this once, she did it twice. And as you know, the basket was an old basket. And when the third time she put broccoli in that basket and she picked up the basket to put it on her head, dhavak, all the broccoli fell down and the basket broke. From the bottom of the basket came off. The rabbit saw it and he started crying. My basket is broken. My basket is broken, he said. The old lady said, "Arey haan, I am so sorry. I did not mean for the basket to break, but it broke." Rabbit said, "Oh, my nice basket I gave you to use nicely and you broke my basket." Old lady said, "See, I'm so sorry. I did not mean it. It broke." So the rabbit said, "Now nothing doing. Now you have to give me something instead of my basket." So old lady said, "What can I give?" He said, he looked at the broccoli and he said, "How about some broccoli?" So the old lady said, "Broccoli? But that though I have to sell in the market and feed my family. How I'll give you broccoli?" So the rabbit said, No. You give me the broccoli, others give me my basket. Give me the broccoli, others giving me my basket." So the old lady was getting tired of this rabbit. So she said, "Acha, see, listen. I can't give you broccoli. But I can give you broccoli leaves, huh? I've got lots of broccoli leaves and they're really yummy, yummy." The old lady thought she'll fool the rabbit. And the rabbit was a little dull fellow. So he said, "Acha, theek hai, fine. Don't give me the broccoli, give me the leaves. Chalo. Quickly cut off the leaves and give it to me. I have lots of work to do." So the old lady, she went and she cut off the broccoli leaves. And she gave it to the rabbit. "Here, take." So the rabbit took all those broccoli leaves. She tied it up in bunches. And she took the broccoli leaves. And she, the rabbit took the broccoli and he started hopping away. Now he hopped. By this time, it had become afternoon. It was really hot sun. And rabbit had started feeling hungry. He went and sat down underneath one tree. And he thought, "Arey, now I'm feeling so hungry. What will I eat? This broccoli leaves she has given me. What will I do with this broccoli leaves? I have no idea." But as he was sitting there, the smell of the broccoli leaves entered his nose. And the rabbit said, "Arey, this smells really nice. Maybe I should eat it and see." And so the rabbit, he picked up one broccoli leaf and very gingerly he put it in his mouth and began nibbling. And guess what? He liked the taste of the broccoli leaves and he said, "Arey, this is so yummy. Till now I'd never ever tasted broccoli and it is so yummy." And he ate and he ate and he ate some more. And he said, "Ah, this is so yummy. I'm not going to share my broccoli leaves with anybody." And then he said to himself, "Ah, what a lovely day I've had. I lost my tail, but I gained a knife. I lost that knife, but I gained a basket. And I lost the basket, but guess what? I now came to know the taste of this broccoli leaves and they are so yummy and I must go and tell all my rabbit friends." And so from that day onwards, all the rabbits, they discovered that broccoli leaves are so yummy. And whenever a rabbit sees a broccoli leaf, what does it do? It goes and eats it up. Yeah. So that is the story of how rabbits discovered their love for broccoli leaves. Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.